Do you like wasting time? No, I didn't think so. So why do we waste so much time when we're managing all of our cards and lists within Trello? Well, today I'm going to help you save time by showing you some of my favorite Butler automation tips. But first, I'd like to thank today's sponsor, Pipedrive. Pipedrive is the easy-to-use CRM system that integrates directly with Trello. To learn more, go to pipedrive.com. When it comes to saving time in Trello using Butler automation, we want to look at things that we do most frequently or most often. And so my first tip for you has to do with dragging something into your final list. In many cases, your final list will have a title such as completed or done or finished. And when you drag something into that list, you often will have a due date remaining. And isn't it time consuming for you to not only drag it over there, but then we have to open up this card, then we have to come over here and check off this due date. So we can get into this green state as we see with these other cards below. Why don't we just have that happen automatically? Well, let's do so with Butler. What we're gonna do is that when this gets dragged over into my completed list, I want to have that due date checked automatically. So let's open up Butler and we are going to select rules, and we need to hit that create rule button and add our first trigger. We're going to stay on this first option, which is card move, and we're going to actually look at the second choice down below. When a card is, and we're going to select moved into, we have to pick a particular list. When a card is moved into the complete list, and I'm going to say by anyone, not just by me, but in case I'm working with a team or if I happen to add other individuals to this board. So when a card is moved into the list complete by anyone, I have to make sure to hit this green button. So that's my trigger at the top. Now I have to tell Butler what is going to happen. So in this case, we actually want to select the date field, because although it is a checkbox, it's attached or it's associated with that completed field or with that due date. So the very first option here is mark the due date as complete. That's exactly what we want. Come over here, hit that green plus button. We can scroll to the top just to review both the trigger and the actions, and let's make sure we hit that save button. So now, if we come back to my board, let's take a look at that exact same card. Remember, it's unchecked. It's due in a few days. I'm going to drag it over here into complete, and boom, there it is. It's changed to green. It has been completed for me, so I don't have to go and open up that card anymore. But how about something else? Here's another one that we have with a due date attached. And what if I'm inside this card and I see that everything has been completed and I want to come up here and check off this due date? Wouldn't it be great by just checking this box? It would automatically move this card into the complete list. Well, let's make that happen. Once again, let's open up Butler, and we are going to stay with our rules. Now, in this case, we're going to create a new rule, and we have to pick a new trigger. So we're going to say add a trigger, and this time we're going to come down to dates. And we are going to say when a due date, the second one here, when a due date is marked as complete in a card. Once again, I'm gonna select by anyone. That is gonna be our trigger. I'm gonna hit that plus button, and now we need to tell it what is going to happen. And what we wanna do is we wanna select this first option here. Under the Move tab, move the card to the top of the list or the bottom of the list. That's up to your personal preference. I'm gonna say to the top of the list, and we are gonna select that complete list. Don't forget to hit that green arrow at the end, because some of these have multiple options. You have to choose multiple choices here, but make sure you hit that green plus button. That will actually add it to your automation. So when the due date is marked as complete in a card by anyone, we want to move that card to the top of the list complete. Let's hit save, and we'll close out our Butler dialog. So here we go. Here is this one. Instead of dragging it over into complete, what I want to do is I'm going to come in here and I'm going to check off this due date box. And what's going to happen? It's not only completed, but you can see up top here, it's already moved us into the list complete. I don't even have to close out this card yet. We've already been moved into complete. And if I do close it, here you can see we are moved to the top of the list. It has been moved to the top of the completed list just by hitting that task bar, just by hitting that checkbox, within that due date. All right, let's go one step further here and let's take a look at how we can add some automation to our custom fields. Because one of the great things about using custom fields within Trello is that you can add some specific information such as client name. Here I have a checkbox called approved. I can even add a particular start date or have multiple dates or due dates here in addition to the main due date within a Trello card. But let's take a closer look at this approved checkbox. Perhaps you have a Trello board where there's a process where it gets to a particular stage, a particular part of your workflow, and then you want some specific actions to be taken. So in this case, what I want to do is that when this approved checkbox is checked, I want the due date to automatically go to 72 hours from now, and I want to assign myself to this particular card. Okay, and we want to do that all with just a single action, just by checking this box. So let's close down this card and let's go back into Butler. We are gonna stick with rules. This is gonna happen under our rules, and we're gonna select create rule once again. Now we wanna add our trigger. Now when it comes to custom fields within the Butler dialog or within the Butler interface, don't be confused. We are not going to check lists. This is a checkbox. It is not a checklist. Custom fields will appear under this last option here labeled fields. So we're gonna select fields, and we might have to scan down here just to see which one best suits us. Now in this case, we want to come down to about the fifth or sixth one here, which says when custom field blank field name is checked by me, or of course we can choose anyone. We can choose different options here, but let's select the proper field name. Now since it's the only checkbox, it's the only custom field checkbox I have, it's going to be my only choice here. So when custom field approved is checked by anyone. Now don't forget, you can actually have different rules for when things are unchecked. But in this case, we want to say when the approved checkbox is checked by anyone, let's hit that plus button. That is the trigger. Now, what do we want to have happen? Well, let's start with the due date. We're going to come down here to dates and we're going to set that due date, not to now. We want to open up this dialog and give us a few more options here. Now, I could choose 3 days if I wanted to. I can change the duration or the scheduling value here. But in this case, I'm going to say 72 hours. I'm going to be really specific. 72 hours from when that checkbox is selected. I'm going to hit this plus button here, which is only going to add it to this level here. Don't forget to hit the green plus button. Set due date in 72 hours, which is actually going to add it as an action. But we're not done just yet. We want to go to members because I want to add someone specifically to this card. The third one down says add member at. Now, this is great if you have other members of your team. Maybe you have a sales associate. Maybe you have a support team member that needs to address these cards when a particular checkbox is selected. Now, in this case, I'm just going to select myself, but don't forget, you can choose specific people if you like. So I'm going to say add member myself to this card as well. Hit that green plus button, and now both of those actions are going to take place. Don't forget, if there is a specific label you also want to add, if there's a comment you would like to add, you can do that here as well. But in this example, we're just gonna leave it for these two. I'm gonna hit save, and let's close out our Butler dialog and see what happens. So we're gonna come up here to this contact client about meeting, and let's say it is approved. So I'm going to select this checkbox and let's see what happens. Up top, first the date quickly jumped in at 72 hours from right now, and I have been assigned to this card, all by a single action, just by checking a single box. This is a great automation to add to some of those processes where, again, you need multiple things to happen and you don't want to waste your time clicking all over that card or even moving things around within your Trello board. Next, let's look at something that's perhaps a little more advanced, and that is adding new lists to your board along with adding some variables. If I scroll over here to the left-hand side of my board, you can see that I've had an automation working for me over the last few days. I've been adding a new list with a very specific title for each of these days. So how this particular automation is working, I had a great question just a week ago about someone who is using Trello for their own personal to-do list. And the way they like to manage it is that they have a new list that they create for each and every new day. But they want that to happen automatically. Well, we can do that here within Butler. Here you can see each morning at a time that I specify, I am getting a new list created at the beginning of my board. But not only is it just a new list, but it has a very specific title with actually that date attached to it. So how did I do it? Well, let's go and create it for ourselves. Once again, we're going to come into Butler, but unlike the other rules that we looked at, we are not going into rules, or I should say other automations. We are not going into rules because this is happening on a scheduling basis. We want to select calendar this time. So once we're in calendar, we want to select create a command. We start with our trigger as always, and this one's pretty straightforward. We're going to just do this one every day. It's going to be the first one here, every day. Now, what you might want to do is click on this little clock icon and specify when this is going to happen. So let's say I'd like this to happen pretty early in the morning. I'm going to say every morning at 5 a.m. That's when I want this new list to appear. So I'm going to hit that plus button. That is our trigger. And now we have to determine what is going to happen. So in this case, I want to choose the third option over, which is titled lists. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this first option, which says create a new list. Okay, so I want to create a new list named. Now here is where we're going to give it a specific name. Now in many cases, if you're creating a new list on a regular basis, you probably don't want to use the exact same name, right? It's going to become confusing, especially if you're creating other automations or other rules to have lists with the exact same name. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say tasks for, and so I can get the accurate date, so I can get that day's date, what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a curly bracket, and I'm going to say date, D-A-T-E, short, S-H O-R-T, all one word, no spaces, date short, and then I'm going to close it with another curly bracket. This is what's called a Butler variable. So what it's going to do, it's going to put in that day's date in a somewhat shortened or abbreviated month format, as you saw on my board before. So that's all we need to do. This is the action, tasks for, and it's going to put in the date for that day. I'm going to hit that plus button over here to the right, and don't forget to hit save. Now this one's a bit harder for me to show you live because it's not going to happen until tomorrow morning at 5 a.m. But what I've already shown you is this is how it's going to look. It's date short because you can see it's only giving me the three letter abbreviation of the month. Instead of the E on June, it's just giving me J-U-N. But let's take a closer look at where you can find out how to add these variables and many more to your Trello board. On the official Trello support website, you can find a full list of all of the variables that you can include within your Butler automation. Now, you can also simply do a quick Google search for Trello Butler variables, and you'll come directly to this page, or I should say it will be the first option in those search results. Once you're here, you will see the full list of all the variables in which you can include. So here under time related, if we scroll down, here you can see that date short, which I just included in my Butler automation. If I wanted date long, I could just input that, and then I could get the full month. Maybe I just want the date number format. I can do that as well. But whether it's time related, and yes, you can do the day before or weeks after or number of days after, you can give it board data. You can even include card data. In fact, this is some of the variables that I will use if I'm creating a custom email notification or adding a comment within a particular card. I can actually add specific links, or I can add other information about that card. But you can scroll and find the full list of all the variables in which you can add here within your Trello Butler automation data. Now, if you want to see your sales data clearly and feel organized every day, you should check out PipeDrive. PipeDrive is the easy-to-use sales tool that you don't need an IT degree to work with. You can visually track your leads, pipelines, and communication in one place and never forget what to follow up about. PipeDrive automates your day so you can spend more time focusing on your customers. You can try PipeDrive free for 30 days and then get 25% off your first 3 months. Click the link in the description to take advantage of this special offer.